I want my life to be legendary. I want you to remember me how I live.
Make her feel good.
I just smoked a soul drug and smoked a soul drug.
Her name is Anonymous.
But he did not call for all the king's horses, and he did not call for all the king's men.
Our enemy is ignorance and hatred.
Slow it down, slow it down.
But you're not listening.
I've been showing people my scars.
Don't go away from me.
Hip-hop's a part of me.
They're recycling the track.
I aim the point shot. She learned to listen and follow my rules of commitment.
When I say CC, you say P. CC. CC. When I say drop the, you say Mike. Drop the.
Mike.
Drop the.
Mike.
Show 2 of Drop the Mic. Please give it up for season 3 of Drop the Mic. We are so excited to be filming another season of Drop the Mic, and we're also super, super excited because we have been nominated for our second Emmy. Season 2 was not nominated for an Emmy, so we were nominated for season 1, 2015 and 2016. Please make some noise for being a 2-time Emmy nominated show. So we are continuing with our second round. So the poets who performed in round 1 will be coming back up to the mic again. It will be a whole new order because I will be randomly selecting the poets in between each performance. And just as a reminder to our audience as well as to our poet contestants that when they come up to the mic that they will be timed. As they're performing. And so the time limit that they have is 3 minutes and 15 seconds. If they go over time, they will have a penalty applied to their final score. And the penalty is that there will be a half a point deduction for each second they go over 3 minutes and 15 seconds, okay, at the end of round 2 off of their total score. And the folks who will be making the decision of who our top 5 poets will be to move on to the final showcase are our amazing and wonderful and beautiful judges. Please give it up for our judges. So we have a very special guest judge today because one of our regular judges, Kevin Covington, who is a support coach in the Center for Male Engagement, couldn't make it today. So we're really happy that our feature poet agreed to sit in today in Kevin's place. So as our guest judge, we have our feature poet, Marquise Wright-Lee. Please make some noise for Marquise. And we'll see Marquise perform a little bit later on in the show. And next to Marquise, we have Elizabeth Catanese. Please give it up for Elizabeth. She is an assistant professor in the English department here at Community College of Philadelphia. And next to Elizabeth, we have Alicia Dantzler. Please give it up for Alicia. Alicia is a graduate of CCP, and she is also a spoken word poet here in the Philadelphia poetry scene. And next to Alicia, we have DeForio Barlow. Please make some noise for DeForio. He is a testing specialist in the Assessment Center here at Community College of Philadelphia. So y'all ready to hear some poetry? I hope so. Please also keep in mind, I just want to remind our audience that it's, you know, really wonderful to give our poets as much support as you possibly can. So if you hear something that the poets are saying that you really enjoy, please let them know it. You can snap your fingers, or you can, you know, talk back to the poets. You can say yeah, or you can clap, or if you want to stomp your feet or whatever. But, you know, the poets are going to really appreciate any show of support that you can give to them, okay? So hopefully you guys will keep that energy up, okay? Thank you so much. Please give it up for our poets who are about to come to the stage. So the poet on deck is Gavin, and coming to the mic to start round 2 is Nonfiction. Please make some noise for Nonfiction.
You know, with this poem, interacting with the crowd is, it's needed because you want them to get the message that you're saying, because if you're just saying words and nobody's receiving the message, what's the point of talking, you know?
Are we really going to pretend that racism in America doesn't exist? Just hang it up in a closet, only like a wedding dress, only using it again when we need it. See, y'all realize black don't crack. Y'all eggshell white skin fall down and don't get back up again, we would have thought you was Humpty Dumpty. But as soon as our smooth ebony skin hits the ground, it doesn't tell us to not get back up. It tells us to get back up and keep pushing. All the trials and tribulations that we have endured over many, many of years, we are evolution at its finest. Crying out for our brothers and sisters, we raise our fist in solitude. Why fist, you say? We raise it as a symbol for Black Panthers. We raise it as a symbol for dashikis and war paint. We raise it to show that our efforts won't be in vain. And when we raise it, let us recognize unity, that a fist is not a fist unless each and every finger is working together. Let us recognize power, because as we punch away our fears and obstacles, we get stronger each and every time. And let us also recognize protection, protecting those who need help or can't even defend themselves against the brutality of life itself. See, when you raise a hand, an open hand, you have a question to ask. But when you raise a fist, you have your answer enclosed by your convictions. And pro-Black doesn't mean anti-white, but how are we going to bring everyone together in unity if we can't bring ourselves together as a community? Our Black brothers and sisters being beaten with batons and nightsticks for crimes they didn't commit, but I can't breathe. You can hear me asking for air, like, please, please, don't kill me, please. They did not damage his spirit, but his skin is no longer pristine. For they have finally cracked the skin of one of our many Black brethren. So now, Black does crack. And they figured out how to do it. It's only a matter of time before we all go through it. Thank you.
I don't know, I was kind of judging myself, but I was, you know, at the same time, they said, be more comfortable. So I said, you gotta throw all that out the window, get really into your poetry. And so that really helped me.
Marquise, you have some feedback?
Yes. You took the suggestion from last time, like when you're reading, you know, you can still like deliver that conviction. So yes, I appreciated that, you know, even though you were reading, you were still able to give yourself. So good job.
Thank you. Elizabeth.
Yeah, a lot of energy, a lot of emotional connection. I love the hand and the fist part of the poem, and then that great line at the end, that it's only a matter of time until we all go through it. Really nice, again, way to end the poem. Good job.
Thank you. Alicia.
I think, just like Marquise said, you did take the advice as well as, you know, taking the time on stage to set yourself, and then you got more into this piece and connected with the crowd.
Thank you. And DeForio.
I think you were definitely more comfortable this time around. I think you really had a better control of the mic. And it was a lot, in terms of performance, I thought it was a lot better than the first.
Thank you. Thank you, judges. One more time for Nonfiction. So the poet on deck is Tierra, and coming to the mic, we have Gavin. Please, put your hands together for Gavin.
I love noticing the different things that other people go through at CCP and really hearing and feeling their pain.
So a couple of quick comments before I start. One, I ask that you clap in the deaf way, which is this, because it is a poem about deaf culture. Two, this has trigger warning rape, so for the next few minutes, do what you gotta do to make yourself feel comfortable. And three, to contextualize it, a loan sign is a fingerspelled word that the letter has been either partially deleted or slightly mutated as a way to create a pattern and or create a faster fingerspelling. So this is the loan sign rape. The loan sign rape has a partial deletion and ever slight mutation, and I wonder if it was a survivor who thought of that, wonder if they did it to show the part of them that changed what feels like forever, show the world that the bruises will last longer than they ever thought possible, and so many cannot be covered by scarves and walking slow. The tears at simple things, the anger at the irrational periodic tables and Cato papers, I wonder if they did it to talk about it. To change it enough to talk about it freely, like the asterisks and trigger warnings, things I do not need but will support fully. People say I speak candidly about the things that happened to me, but people don't ask what's next to lithium. And I can smile and laugh at the idea of getting over this, at the idea that there will never be just another rape poem ripped from my fingertips. The loan sign rape has a partial deletion and ever slight mutation. And I really wonder why it was made that way, who needed rape to be a lone sign. Perhaps it was the perpetrators who wanted to normalize it, create a pattern they used against us, up, down, mocking us, making the world less serious, excusing themselves from their actions and allowing it to happen again and again. The lone sign rape has a partial deletion and ever slight mutation. I learned it in class by watching a room full of people scream it with their hands. The teacher said he was very understanding, said he couldn't possibly know, and that's true, but how can you? When the bruises on my neck have already faded, but that doesn't mean I will let anyone touch it. Still mangled, still bruised. Once well known for hickeys, king of all sluts, there is now a partial deletion for my favorite act. My teacher asked if I want to interpret, implying that this is something I need to just put up with, but I already do when you put it on a vocabulary list next to a bank. And spoiled, when I am not paid to put up with this, when I am not complaining for complaints, say, who made the lone sign rape that partial deletion? That!
Yes, keep your applause going for Gavin, everyone. Yes. Elizabeth, you have some feedback.
That is so powerful. The poem is such an important topic, and I could feel that you meant every word that you were saying, and I'm just so glad that you're in this competition and that you're a poet.
Thank you. Alicia.
Samira, what Elizabeth said, I agree, as well as just the fact that we need more poets like you that's not afraid to get up there and bare their soul, and you can feel it in their voice, their tone, their expression. So thank you.
Thank you. DeForio.
The deep breaths were really serious to me, and I think that's what kind of held me in the whole time. So.
And Marquise.
Yes, I appreciated the content of the poem, everything. It's kind of hard to ask this, but like, I know like you're in the moment in delivering the poem, but like, if you could slow it down just a little bit, because there was just a lot going on. So, that's the only thing I have. And thank you.
Thank you so much, judges. Please, one more time for Gavin. Thank you. So the poet on deck is Black Cancer. Coming to the mic, we have De'Ara. Please make some noise for De'Ara.
Hello. This poem is entitled Love Me. I keep wondering what it's like to be without you. The effect it would have over me. I am suffering. I can feel it as the tears rush down my face, wounding my eyelids. This pain is like an adrenaline. It's a sudden rush for me. It sparks the fuel to my anger. My sweetness turns bitter. My heart goes cold, and instead of leaving you, I abuse you with my words. My hateful remarks engrave upon your heart like a branding, never to be removed or unspoken, yet by morning I hope all is forgiven. Baby, I love you. You are the air that fills my lungs, allowing me to breathe. Baby, I love you. You are the food that provides its nourishment to sustain my living. Baby, I love you. You are my remedy when I am left wounded. Baby, I love you. You are my inner peace during a time of chaos. Baby, I love you. You are my strength when I am left powerless. Baby, I love you. You are my diary when no one cares to listen. Baby, I love you. You are my shelter from destruction. Baby, I love you. You are the water that maintains my body, essential to my being. Baby, I love you. You are the light that guides my path to safety. Baby, I love you. You are my one true everlasting love. I love you, but just as you are my air, you leave me breathless. Just as you are my nourishment, you have left me starved. Just as you are my remedy, you leave me wounded. And just as you are my strength, you have left me powerless. But I love you because for all the times you leave me neglected, you have always restored my existence with the simplest of words. De'Ara, I love you.
One more time for De'Ara. Great job. Alicia, do you have some feedback?
Yeah. What I like about the poem that you did, your repetition, sometimes it can, for like some people, it can get old, but what I like is what you did, you brought us another side each time. And then you also brought in another idea and brought that repetition another side each time. So you did a good job at creating it.
Thank you. DeForio.
Just to piggyback off of Alicia, I think with the repetition, I wanted a little more feeling and emotion in it. I think that would have brought it home for me. All right.
Thank you. Marquise.
Question. Is this your first time, like, performing? Okay. All right. All makes sense now. You know, I appreciate just your openness and willingness, you know, to share and be up here on stage. So even, you know, this, especially this being your first time and you're in front of cameras and all this shit. So, you know, I just appreciate and, yeah. So yeah, I just appreciate you for that.
Thank you. And Elizabeth.
I really like your poetry. The poems themselves are quieter poems, so it's hard to then to perform in an outward way the quiet words and emotions. I liked the repetition as well, and I wonder if you could play within that poem about where you put the repeated phrases, just move things around a little bit just to see how they work. But I really, great job. I really liked it.
Thank you, judges. Please put your hands together one more time for De'Ara. So the poet on deck is Dar the Poet. And coming to the mic, we have Black Cancer. Please put your hands together for Black Cancer.
Police brutality has happened to me before, not so much as being beat down, but just being pulled out of the car, being accused of having this, that, and the third, and we didn't have anything at all.
So when I say dirty, y'all say pigs. Dirty, dirty. Dispatch, 1034. There's 5 gangsters in a car. In pursuit. We think they're trafficking drugs. I'm gonna proceed with caution. Over and out. Woo! Pull over. Pull over. The lights say, red and blue target in my V. Not a legit cause for any light rays. It's just the fact it's a Friday. Got 5 gangsters in a car. Approach cautious for I tell what it's for. Run ID and tags, they'll come across. You know these gangsters can't tell them apart.
Man, why you stop me? Tell me why you stop me. And accused all of us of blowing broccoli. Try to play me like I'm sweet. Fuck Mr. Nice Guy, that is not me. All my papers legit. You need a copy? Stop me for DWB. You little Nazi, die please. We are not friends. And only green in my car is my Benz. Cause I'm cuffing in my ends. And you fuckers try to cuff me for nothing. Make assumptions and cussing? I hope you get fucked up as Russian liquor, nigga, dirty pigs. Pigs, 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 dirty pigs. Pigs, dirty motherfucking pigs. Excessive force the pigs too. Cause they scorn with issues. And they take it out on us when they frisk you. Dirty motherfucking pigs. Got weed on you, nigga, then you better tuck. Got guns on you, nigga, put the metal up. The pigs don't care if you innocent. They just profile as you ignorant.
Oh, I see I got a wise guy on my hand. Complaining about his lights like I give a damn. Fuck out the car before I fire my ham. Well, Taz, your black ass, you try me again. See you on some bullshit. I ain't even forward. Your threats I'm ignoring. Plus you're recorded.
Your nuts is enormous till they get cracked. And your homies tell them get back. For I throw all your ass in the pad. The law's God, now bet against that.
And I will, cause I'm never with that. I will never sit back while the law try to draw putting fear up in blacks. Fuck you, pig. If a nigga knows right, you ain't cuffing shit, bitch. I must admit, they still got advantage. It's they word over eyes when things finish. But I ain't for the yamming or CSCF cause they scamming. They handing time like our clocks broke. While a lot of us down and not up. Get a joy out of Blockbuster. Fucking niggas money and they life up in a process. Dirty, 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 dirty motherfucking pigs. Yeah.
Black Cancer! Keep your applause going for Black Cancer. DeForio, yes,
you okay? Because I'm getting angry too. I completely understand.
I've been through a lot.
I think it was real.
It was a real story,
real really thing happened. That's happening right now, right today. It was perfect. It was on point to me.
Thank you. Marquise.
So I pull over to the side of the road. I heard, son, do you know what I'm stopping you for? Because I'm young and I'm black. That's just like that whole scenario just reminded me of like that
so
whole verse. So yeah.
Thank you. Elizabeth.
Yeah, I think we need more poems that are about racial profiling, and I like that the whole poem was about that topic and that you had the way that you were performing on stage and turning one way and then the other. Mm-hmm. That was really powerful. It was theatrical as well as important as a poem.
Thank you. And Alicia.
Yeah, Tamir, what Elizabeth said, I like the animation of going back and forth between yourself and then the cops, as well as just the anger, because I'm like, yo, I feel like I'm in the car. You know, I'm ready to be, you know, I'm your homie. What's going on? Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, you brought that to us, so thank you for letting us in to that moment.
Thank you, judges. Please, one more time for Black Cancer. So after our next poet will be our feature poet, Marquise. And then to begin the second part of round two will be Lil SV. But coming to the mic now, we have Dar the Poet. Please put your hands together for Dar the Poet.
Well, every single time I get on stage, it's a difference because it's a new time, it's a new energy, it's a new atmosphere, even though it's the same place.
If I were a flower, what kind would I be? A chrysanthemum, proud and bright, a bird of paradise, always in flight, or a delicious, delectable, fragrant-smelling rose with petals so tight, only opening upon its delight. With juice so sweet, a treat to eat, but not for everyone it meets. If I were a flower, what kind would I be? A cactus, an aloe, or maybe even a season-only blooming poinsettia, a lily so fine, a hint of divine. If I were a flower, what kind would I be? The only kind acceptable for a lady like me.
Give it up one more time for Dar the Poet. Marquise, you have some feedback?
I absolutely just love your stage presence. Sometimes it's just like, sometimes your stage presence is honestly just bigger than a poem, to be honest. Like, I have to like really draw myself and like, oh yeah, she's actually talking. And like, it's just like so much just confidence and stuff like that. So I absolutely love it.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
Yeah, I admire the confidence too, and I loved that the way that you were talking about flowers and then relating them to the self and identity, and it made it just super interesting. So wonderful job, great job.
Thank you, Alicia.
First and foremost, I like the way, you know, when you get on stage and you start walking, you got the click and the click and the click and the click, and then you start to perform, and it's just so, you're so into it. And then you lighten the mood with the poem as well. So I like to be able to have a poem like that that can lighten the mood as well.
Thank you. And DeForio.
I think throughout that performance, you kind of bloomed like a flower. And it just got better and better as you went along. So good job.
Thank you, judges. Please, one more time for Dar the Poet. So just as a reminder, after our feature poet, we have Lil SV. But right now, I'm just really excited to be able to introduce to you, you know, Marquise has been performing as our guest judge this afternoon, and we're really fortunate that he was, you know, willing to do that while also being our feature poet. This is someone who I've seen grow as a spoken word artist over the last few years. He's someone who is very close to my heart. He's someone that I consider to be part of my family. So I hope you all will show him a lot of love. Please give it up for Marquise.
white man ain't no friend to the nigga. The white man ain't no friend to the nigga. Will conjure the devil to prove what kind of power he has over this land. I was a free man. The type of free that could dig his toes in the soil on the outside of the plantation. Ain't nobody come looking for him. The kind that could wear his smile like the only clothes he owned and ain't have to take them off if he ain't want to. I was a free man. Free from the field, from working in it, living in it, breathing in it so much I could pick the cotton from my lungs. Ain't have to sleep in a shack where we used each other's bodies as bedding. I lied out loud long enough that calling another man master didn't make my tongue bleed from the sin. Watch whites watch defiant bodies dangle from tree trunks and sway in the wind like the pendulum on a grandfather clock just to pass the time. Been beat for staring at the stars for too long trying to figure out their freedom. On how to get my own, I talked to them. Asked they secrets, got jealous of they shine, how it can never be captured, and I think they hurt me. Cause when Master died of his own evil, coming back on him and claiming his heart, and his wife ran off with a white man that ain't wanna be bothered with no slaves, I got my shine. We got our freedom papers and washed our skin, shed old life. I felt my body break down from the pressure of being my own master. I smiled and cried and celebrated the devil out my life. I was a free man walking down the sidewalk like I belong there. My feet kissed the ground like an old lover with each step. I was moving on purpose, with purpose. For a white man asked me, where your papers, boy? And I showed it to him like a new heart, beating fresh for the first time. I gave him my freedom as if it was my most prized possession. I showed him my freedom. And he showed me how he felt, how one piece of paper became two, became four, became fire, became ashes. He asked me again, where your papers, boy? But I'm a free man. Became more white men. He asked me again, where your papers, boy? Became anger. Became clenched fist and bloody nose white man. Became blow to a nigga's head, forced to kiss the store window and give it a coat of fresh blood. But I was a free man. My name is Marquise Wright Lee. Thank you for listening.
Please give it up one more time for Marquise. Thank you so much, Marquise. And please, let's give it up one more time for all the poets who performed in the first half of round two of Audition Show 2. We have five more student poets who will be coming to the stage. On deck, we have Shawnee D. And coming to the mic, we have Lil SV. Please make some noise for Lil SV.
My goal is to express the things that some people are afraid to talk about.
Before I start, give it up for yourself one time. I know I probably scared a few people my last one, but y'all mind if be nice for a moment? All right. I'll try my best to be a true gentleman. Something about my chocolate sweet brings me comfort like new track sneaks. The courage and words she speaks, the way she loved me, it makes her ex weep. Don't go away from me, you can stay till eternity. You my one and only lady. No one else deserves my baby, a place in my heart for you. A love lasts long because you came to me honestly true. Shit, you never doubted me. Shit, you made me believe. I never felt this way in a long time. I mean, for once, she want me for hers for all time. I remember our first moment. I said hi, you just kept going. Later finding that, you said hi back. But it was so low, I ain't get to hear all that. Probably because I was with my team blowing weed. I used to think absurd dreams. I mean, dying heartbroken alone. Man, them fantasies is way out my zone. Since I felt my new lady and my new baby, I will cock the chrome. See, Romeo got nothing on mine. She could run like the wild coyote, and I'll be the crazy Don. We had the DBs on our private anniversaries. You know what real love is? That's staying married, with or without kids. Shit, I look to pull a Huxtable. The passion for her is unstoppable. I mean, it's the best project of Cupid yet. It got me wide open like the old Phillies vet. Hey, I ain't stupid. I know what I'm doing. I got family now. My life is not ruined.
One more time for Lil SV. Elizabeth, do you have some feedback?
Yeah, nice, you're very versatile. That was great. I liked the sort of softer poem. I liked that you took your jacket off and showed us this other side. Very nice.
Thank you.
Thank you. Alicia.
I'm a Gemini. You just did some Gemini stuff, you know. You really went from shoot 'em up, bang bang, to my heart or whatever. So, I mean, I appreciate it. But no, on another note, I like the way you got up there and you did set yourself up on stage and you gave us another side of you. So thank you.
Thank you. DeForio.
I think it's important for men to show other men that we are also vulnerable. I think you did a good job with that.
Absolutely.
Thank you. And Marquise.
Yeah, DeForio, that's what I was going to say. Yeah, shout out to man. Shout out to man showing his feelings. That's right, big man.
Right on.
Thank you, judges. Please give it up one more time for Lil SV. So on deck, we have Logical. But coming to the mic, we have Shawnee D. Please make some noise for Shawnee D.
This time it was more like just an aggressive song. I was just angry.
I am about to just do my own thing. Shawnee D is killing it in the game. I am the murderous murderer, murdering suckers with no fear, cause I'm not afraid. I rap with aggression, I'm showing the rage. I'm always angry, just look at my face. I don't play games, I'm the cause of destruction as soon as I put my 2 feet on the stage. I'm the one who'll wipe you out in really any second. Keep playing with me and I swear you're the one that I'll be wrecking. This where your life's dependent. Me, I am a lethal weapon. I'll destroy your world and I'll destroy you like it's Armageddon. Yo, I'm going to blow. I am a psycho, lyrically though. I am untouchable up in the industry. I am a bomb that's going to explode. I am not nice, my heart is so cold. Hip hop's a part of me, that makes me whole. I am not childish like the Gambino when it comes to rapping and killing the flow. I am a beast, I am the greatest, I'm never the least. I'ma just feast on all of you rappers cause all I do is really eat MCs. I was passed the torch, and the torch that was passed is the torch I'm gonna use to burn every one of you to ash. If I'm in your city, we go in a war, so I suggest that you pray to the Lord. When I start spitting, I'm murdering y'all, and there's no turning back, so listen furthermore. I will continue to murder you all. I'm the king rising, I never fall. All of you suckers do have many flaws. Keep messing with me and I'm breaking your jaw. Killed many suckers cause my bars are raw. I am so vicious, more vicious than Saul. It should just really be against the law for me to just constantly really kill y'all. But it's my honor to put you to death. It is my pleasure, it's what I do best. Go ahead and try to put me to the test, but I'm still going to put your body to rest. Going up against me is a very dangerous situation. We going head to head and your head's what I'm decapitating. If you got a wall built around you, guess what, I'm straight penetrating. Underrating Shawnee D, that is where you've all mistaken. I'm the king of everybody. I'm the ruler of every zone. Suckers still keep hating on me cause I got their girl on the phone. I don't want her dirty, dumb self anyway, she's stupid. I'm just showing if I wanted to take your girl, then I could do it. I'm the king. I'm the king of everything. I'm the king of the industry, the champ in every ring. When I step in your city, I better get my crown. If not, I'm getting busy and I'll shut you suckers down.
Shawnee D, put your hands together one more time for Shawnee D. Alicia, do you have some feedback?
Yeah, I like the way you enunciate. And then you actually took the advice and tried to, you looked up here, I saw your eyes. As well as I saw you looking at the audience as well, trying to connect with the crowd as well.
Thank you. DeForio.
I thought a much better connection on this performance, for sure. I felt more confidence from you this particular time, and I really liked your style and your flow.
Thank you. Marquise.
So, I feel like I'm about to give a whole thesis statement. Everybody's waiting on my word. So there are no rules to anything, right? But what I would like to see from you, like maybe in the future, as instead of like, you know, like grabbing the mic and, you know, going all MC on it, to like leave the mic where it is and focus on, as you're rapping, because, you know, you already know the words, as you're rapping, to focus on what the rest of your body's doing. Because you had this like back and forth kind of like, you had a track, right? And you were just staying in that. So I would like, it's probably unconscious, but like I would like for you like to get that performance of, you know, you controlling your body, you know what your body's doing at, you know, all points in time. So it's, so it all wraps up into each other, right?
Thank you. And Elizabeth.
Yeah, I like that you took the advice, you slowed it down. In terms of the poem itself, I felt like I wasn't as connecting as much to the poem, but I was definitely connecting to the performance of your piece. So good job.
Thank you, judges. One more time for Shawnee D. So the poet on deck is Nick, and coming to the mic, we have Logical. Please make some noise for Logical.
Definitely feel it's a spiritual, intrinsic connection going on in here right now.
Is it just me, or does rap seem empty? I'm guessing it's because they're environmentally friendly, see? They take an old track with a R&B or rap, add a catchy chorus and a catchy video to match. They change a couple words and put a shorty in the back. They make a catchy phrase and a dance for the track. They make a remix, tell the DJ bring it back, all to distract the fact they're recycling the track. I think that's why it's getting whack. That's why I nod my head and frown every time I hear a ooh from the back. I'm confused, see, I never hear the truth on a track. They say they keep it real, but they never state the facts. I'm scared rap's headed on a path. Nobody's original, we steal from the past. It's like everybody took an old school class. Cheated on the test, threw the answers in the trash. Skip longevity, that's why they never last. How many one-hit wonders have we had? Maybe you're cool with it. I'm really, really mad. See, that doesn't cover all of it. That's maybe only half. I'm hating on the poets, not studying the craft. Hip-hop's not a job, it's an honorary task. The voice of the people, the painters of a path, the hope for the future, the bridge to the past. See, it's not about you and a chase for the cash. It's about us and a dream once had. A world not ruled by the things of the past. A man never judged for the things that he has. The color of his skin or his economic class. The value of a woman never thrown in the trash. Where old school and new school don't constantly clash. Where church is the school and we all attend class. We should provoke thought with our music. If thought turns to action, it causes a movement. Tell them what the struggle's like. Tell them what your views is. Tell them about the word of God and tell them no excuses. If rap is a tool, we must carefully use it. We only get one shot. We miss, then we lose this. We cannot allow any more to abuse this. Christ is the anchor, man. Tell them what the news is. We will take back what you took. I hear the hard wisdom, they put it in a book, because that would be the last place we would ever look. So my God had a plan that could get the game shook. Put every chapter in a bar, title in the hook. Start with the Bible, 66 books. Genesis is first, let Psalms be the hook. So if rap is a crime, I'm a Christ-driven crook. That means if every rapper is a leader in a sense, just because he makes money doesn't mean he makes sense. I pray we all examine what his lyrics really meant, because we should never clap, we should always take offense. That means if every rapper is a leader in a sense, just because he makes money doesn't mean he makes sense. I pray we all examine what his lyrics really meant, because we should never clap, we should always take offense. Amen. Amen.
Show your love one more time for Logical. De
Sephora, do you have some feedback?
I'm gonna just read what I wrote. Crafty, clever, creative, and pretty dope.
Thank you, Marquise.
I just feel like I was just put back in school, like I'm paying tuition somewhere right now. Professor just came up, like gave a lesson, like once we step out here, it's gonna be a pop quiz and shit. Like, it was like you was up here, he's like, this is what it is, all right? You listening? Cause I'm delivering, okay.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
I loved how you started with rap and then you took us further and really broadened out. So I really like the message that you have and the way that you craft your message. Really nice.
And Alicia.
There you go with the logical thing again, you know? No, but same thing as Elizabeth. I like the way you started off with rap and then it kind of went from rap to a sermon. And I'm like, I like the way you had that connection and you were able to bridge that gap.
Thank you, judges. Please make some noise one more time for Logical. So the poet on deck and the poet who will be closing out round two is Meek Boss. And coming to the mic, we have Nick. Please make some noise for Nick.
This poem is like about the idea of like being in love, but not giving that love back.
This poem is called Love Me. Love me. I'm not looking to be in love, yet I would love to be loved. Not admired like the gods, but genuinely loved. To be loved is different than being in love with someone. To be loved is like warm wine on a winter day. It's comforting in sips. To be in love is like being high, a false escape from reality, and the high will only last so long. To be loved is like that second helping of cornbread. You always get much more than you need. You are full and content and satisfied. To be in love is like buying jewelry. You keep buying for momentary satisfaction. You buy and buy, you buy the whole store, yet it's still not enough. I want you to love me. Love me like a lost child in search of a home. Love me like an abused dog in desperate need of rehabilitation. Love me. Tell me truth so wicked that my eardrums may puncture. Give me what I need. Love me like a broken dream. Give me life. Give me reason to exist. Love me like I should love myself. Help me see value in the disaster. Wrap me up like the dead, then resurrect me. Love me. Run rapid with me in a hurricane. Build up this broken building. Help me clean up this debris. Love me. If you can dodge my lightning bolts, dodge my rain of razors, tiptoe around my broken glass, carry my luggage that holds my past, love me. Love me till you've grown bitter and tired, till you've developed depression and anxiety. Loving me may turn you black and blue. You'll be ugly and cracked, dismembered and hacked. Loving me may alter you. You'll be sick and attached, but don't expect me to love you back. Thank you.
Give it up one more time for Nick. You have some feedback, Marquise, for Nick?
You know what, I'm not entirely sure. I mean, you good on you, like, yeah, like sometimes it's just lost words. It's just, you good on you.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
I was surprised by the ending line, don't expect me to love you back. That was really, I liked that, you know, and it sort of, because there was so much going on in the poem itself, love kind of is like that. It's like complicated. You had so many different ways of expressing love. So I guess the only thing would be to slow down before delivering that last line because we're already thinking about so many different things. But I also thought that you were even more emotionally connected to your poem this time. So good job.
Thank you. Alicia.
I'm going to disagree with Elizabeth because I wanted some love back. No, but seriously, you're one of the poets that I would love to read. Like, you can share your poems, but like I feel like on a page, like just looking at your work, you're a poet that I would love to like read your material and be able to internalize it for myself. I think you're really a dope writer.
Thank you. And DeForio.
I was like, once again, another brother who is sensitive, but then you changed it up. I was like, damn it.
And I think that was the best part of it, that you changed it up. So, good job.
Thank you, judges. Please, one more time for Nick. So, closing out round two, we have Meek Boss. Please make some noise for Meek Boss.
Where I'm from in society, period, Philadelphia, period, just, again, police brutality and just the troubled school systems and our youth and just coming up in these troublesome situations.
What's going on? First of all, I want to say good job, everybody. Where I'm from. I'm from fallen homes and wire fences, drug zones and littered trenches, where folks hide in to avoid their truth, a place where the school system has turned its back on our youth, where our kids roll dice and distribute coke, where death is common because life's revoked. I'm from a place where parents cry daily from losing hope. Don't shoot, my brother yelled but was ignored. These cops harass and kill us when they're bored. And we blacks try to hone the pain of our brothers and sisters murdered in vain. Another news feed, poor black kid shot close aim. Man, that poor black kid has a name. Don't shoot. Hands held high in the air. Hands of mothers and fathers raised in despair. Don't shoot. Stop killing off our roots. I can't breathe in all this toxic waste. I can't understand why my brother had to leave this place. Our body parts missing, such a mystery, and politicians treat colored skin so differently. They torment us and strip our victory, then kill us off to erase our history. United we stand? Shit, that can't be right. Not when love revolves around who's black or white. World destruction is on the way if we don't make the change. Today, I'm Meek.
Keep your applause going for Meek Boss. Elizabeth, do you have some feedback?
I think that's a great way to end about the idea of change and the importance of making a change. And I think your poem and all the poems today were really fantastic because they are about the importance of your voices to help make change that's really needed. I liked that it was also, you began with the where I'm from format and then expanded from there. Nice job.
Thank you. Alicia.
I feel like you have a way of asking questions, not for the sake of getting an answer, but to force people to ask themselves that same question. And I like the way you deliver that in your poems.
Thank you. DeForio.
I think the raspiness and the tone of your voice really helps translate exactly what you mean when you tell your story. I think you did a good job with that.
Thank you. And Marquise.
What DeForio said, you have a very good way of getting across, you know, what you want to say and delivering it. Make sure, you feel in the words, you had this kind of, twisting back and forth, and it was all good. You know, like I said, ain't no rules, nothing, but, just make sure, you deliver, your work through you, not just through the words.
Thank you, judges. One more time for Meek Boss. And can we have another round of applause for all of our poets who performed in Audition Show 2? So that brings round two to an end. At this time, our judges are going to tabulate the scores from round one and round two, and then we are going to announce our top five poets who will be moving on to the final showcase next Tuesday. And while the judges are doing that, we're actually going to have another performance by our guest judge and our feature poet, Marquise. So I hope you all will show lots of love once again for Marquise.
Ain't we all been here before? Dreaming a dream of sleep that comes like a coffin in the night when it's baking cookies? Haven't you opened the oven and seen the light life gleam when it's supposed to? I heard that on the other side, we was born free. but we die hard. And we live soft. There's a brick road leading outside, but I ain't seen it go nowhere. You see the car passing by every day, but it ain't going nowhere. But we all been here before, right here in this space, and in this space, don't we live the same way this space is supposed to be? Aren't we here for a specific reason that says nothing at all? I heard on the test of life that it's just testing. And we all gonna pass if we try. But we can't try if we don't know the answers, but isn't the answer right there when you gave the question? And I'll be right here if we asked it. There's no way to give the answer if the answer isn't there. See, I seen the sky tonight. It was blue. But that was only when the light refracted. See, the light is an unspeakable. Something we can't mention, but we mention it anyway. See, aren't you here with me right now? I wasn't supposed to be God, but here I am crucified on the lips of a speaker that ain't been speaking much. And ain't been dealing in nothing, but see, we gotta let that sink in. It's been knocking for 2 minutes, boy, let that sink in, see. We've been here. And we will be here no matter how many times we do it. See, I went outside and saw the boy standing next to the flower garden. I told him to water those. He came back from the kitchen with two plastic things. I asked him, what are those, see? I've tasted the moistest of biscuits. I've seen the chicken crackle on the stove, see? You see, life is kind of like fast food, you know, draining in the life's essence of the grease, and we've all been to Popeye's. We've all eaten the spinach and gotten our strength, but Lord knows we ain't been strong all the time. See, we weak sometimes. We ain't got the strength. Sometimes we hard as day-old biscuits, and I don't know if I can pay these fees no more. The taxes is too strong here. The chicken ain't cooked all the way. Salmonella is coursing through our veins, and this country is poison. But the sauce is sometimes sweet. And the employment is sometimes good, but sometimes them checks be looking like, oh my God. I repeat, oh my God. See, he answers my prayers. He gave me a promotion, said, go on, buy you something nice. Go on, get some sweet heat. I said, what's that? He said, you'll find out at the end of the crossroads. But we've all cleansed ourselves. We've all been in the bath of life, see, trying to wash off the poison, and I don't know. I may have been here before with you, but I only got one friend in this world. Ernie said it best, rubber ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. See, we've tried to cleanse ourselves from the God's feet, but we all devils sometimes. We've all seen Mary Poppins. Popping on the ab like she worth something, like them penguins ain't got a job, but see, they worked hard for their money. And they can't pronounce all the words. See, who said penguins can talk? I don't know. But they black in a white space. And they white, but it's all right, it's all right. No shame of your color, see. We all drifting on the sea.
trying to find land, but sometimes the trees don't grow the way we want them to. So we get to a new island, see the sailboat sinking in the sunset, and we can't save everybody. You can't be everybody, but sometimes you can be somebody's chocolate chip. You can be their sweet thing. And this whole thing has gone off course so much, it broke his leg. But we still wobbling on to the music. Cause we got the music in our hearts. We got the music in our souls. We are on the path of righteousness, trailing straight to the grassy high. You seen Wheelchair Jimmy, didn't you? You seen how he came up. Your come up is ready, girl. You on the path from niggas to God. I don't know. All right, Michelle, you ready? This has been the most arduous thing. I worked for this goddamn feature. I have worked this. All right.
We're ready. Give it up one more time for Marquise. Can you show your love for Marquise one more time? Feature poet. Guest judge. Also, can we give it up for all of our student poets who performed today? They all did an amazing job, and you guys were awesome as well. Give it up for yourselves. You've been a great audience. I just want to say really quickly before I announce the poets who will be moving on to the final showcase, you know, I always have these moments, and I always seem to end. I know sometimes my students are like, oh my God, here she go again, right? But it's like, it's moments like these where I just feel so happy that I could cry, because this is what it is that, you know, I really want to do here at Community College of Philadelphia with Drop the Mic, to have such amazing colleagues, right, who are judges. Can we give it up for our judges? DeForio, Alicia, Elizabeth, and Kevin, who isn't here, but of course our guest judge once again, Marquise, who care about students, you know, and who want so much to celebrate our students. And as I was saying before the show started, you know, celebrating our students for being their authentic selves, for being your authentic selves, okay? So thank you so much for being here and sharing those moments with us and with all of our poets who shared such amazing, profound, heartfelt poetry. Thank you. Thank you all so much. One more time, please give it up for yourselves. So I just want to let you know that instead of 5 poets going on to the final showcase next Tuesday, October 25th, there are 6. There are 6 poets who will be going on to the final showcase. So I'm going to call out the names in no particular order. And if I call out your name, please come up to the stage and please stand behind me, okay? Like, not over here, but like right behind me, okay? Behind the mic, all right? So in no particular order, the first poet moving on to the final showcase, Logical. Please make some noise for Logical. The next poet who is moving on to the final showcase, Meek Boss. Please put your hands together for Meek Boss. The next poet moving on to the final showcase is Black Cancer. Please show your love for Black Cancer. The next poet is Gavin. Please make some noise for Gavin. The next poet moving on to the final showcase is Nonfiction. Make some noise for Nonfiction. And the last poet who will be moving on to the final showcase is Dar the Poet. Please put your hands together for Dar the Poet, and please give it up for our top 6 poets who will be moving on to the final showcase.